Is Word the Street with your Uncle Nick. I'm the bipolar, biracial bastard, the motherfucking lone wolf, the black Italian stallion. Uncle Nick is here to do motherfucking work, and if you don't know, you better ask somebody. The niggas, the bitches, the ladies, the gents, the rats, the cats, the motherfucking dogs, the babies, the aliens, the reptiles, the motherfucking reptilians. Ask them all. Uncle Nick gets down for the come up in a New York minute, bitch. You know what I'm saying? Stop fucking playing with me. I'm Sicilian, but I'm not a square. You know what I mean? Bada bang, bada boom, boom. Boom, motherfuckers. Let's get this shit popping. Shout out the motherfucking Wolfpack. Shout out everybody in the comment section. All the old subscribers, all the new subscribers, everybody hitting that notification button. And most of all, everybody that donates to the show. Pat yourselves on the back. Drip, drip, drip fills the bucket, nah, man. But without further ado, further delay, let's get into our programming and let's get this shit popping. Let's go. Now I want to give a shout out to Desus and Mero representing the Boogie Down, you know? And I really started fucking with these dudes after they got at DJ Envy, you know what I mean? They were relentless. That's what you're supposed to do. You're supposed to give them that work. Then when it sunned them up there at the radio station, because he tried to get out of pocket like he was going to get all gangster. Slow that shit down, Rashawn Casey. Do your job, man. Play your position, man. Don't have your wife out here making you look crazy. But it was what it was. And then they continued to flame his ass episode after episode. And they just did they thug dizzle. So salute to them dudes, man. I really respect that. Yeah, I'ma get into it. They got a new deal and all this shit popping off. But when I first started doing videos, I got on the internet and all that, I thought like DJ Academics was the man or something like that. You know what I mean? I thought like that was the highest plateau that you could reach. You get a lot of views on YouTube, you get your little money, and that's that. You know what I mean? Because I'm not some fucking trained actor or comedian and shit like that. I'm just a nigga from New York, be going to jail, fucking around, changed my life around, and I'm doing my thing, and I'm just humorous in my own motherfucking way. This shit ain't no acting, nothing like that. So I didn't think that there would be many avenues for motherfuckers such as myself, but I started watching Desus Mero, Nori, a few other people, and I'm like, yo, these dudes are blowing up, man. They're getting podcast deals, they're getting motherfucking shows, networks are picking them up and stuff like that. So I'm like, yo, hold up. Uncle Nick gotta put in this work and do his thing. So it's been really inspirational watching Desus and Mero and a few other motherfuckers that I fuck with do their thing and get the way they at right now. So now I was reading this little article and I came across some shit that Desus and Mero signed this new deal with Showtime. You got Charlamagne the God over there fucking with HBO. Now you got Desus and Mero fucking with Showtime. And it's good to see black men excelling and getting their motherfucking props, getting their own shows, doing their things, and putting other motherfuckers on within the industry, you know what I mean? Now where there's joy, there has to be a little bit of pain at the end of the day, right? So I'm breaking down this article, I'm reading it, and it gets to a certain point where it seems like Vice is on some stank shit at the end of the day. Like, they over here terminated their contracts early or something like that. They still got 2 months left with them, so we'll still see episode and things going down. But they started breaking down the whole workflow, how things go and shit like that. And that's what inspired me even more, dog, because I don't have no writers. I don't have anybody, no fucking motherfuckers giving me ideas and shit. Your Uncle Nick, do this, do that. I just get over here on the camera. I have some fucking thoughts. Blah, out, and I fucking bring this shit to life. So that's exactly what they do. They were like, yo, Vice wants 160 episodes a year and shit like that. Well, pay us $160 million, motherfucker. They had the highest rated show over there. They were busting their ass. And they said it started to kind of conflict with their lives and stuff like that. You're missing graduations. You're missing this. You're missing that. They got kids. They want to spend their time with their wives and stuff like that. They're over there in Williamsburg in some little ass studio busting it down all day long. You know what I mean? But at the end of the day, you got to look at it where they're coming from, too. They're like, yo, we picked you up from Complex. Y'all motherfuckers wasn't doing much over there, you know what I mean? We brought you over here. Now y'all got this deal with Showtime. You want to act all fancy and shit. Niggas like, slow that down. We put the work in. So touche, you know what I mean? It can go both ways and stuff like that. But I'm riding with Desus and Mero. Someone's like, yo, you need to have someone over here massaging my feet, rubbing my back, rolling my blunts, pouring my cognac in my glass, and doing it right for us. Because we over here extending ourselves beyond belief, you know what I mean? And putting in the numbers along with the work. Because, yo, you can put in mad work, but if the numbers ain't there, who really gonna give a fuck at the end of the day? That's what Uncle Nick goes through sometimes. I think I should have mad subscribers and fucking views and shit like that. But I just realized motherfuckers are scared to make me popular at this point, you know what I mean? So all these things that I see other people go through, you know what I'm saying, when they get their deals and shit like that, it just inspires me, but also teaches me things, because I'm not these people getting this money and stuff like that. But you can always learn something from all these scenarios if you plan on going where these motherfuckers is gonna go, because Uncle Nick's gonna make it to the top. So one thing I take away from all these fucking scenarios, this is business. It's never personal at the end of the day. And if you start getting personal with people, thinking you have friends, or this one's riding with you, or let me overextend myself because that's the moral thing to do and shit, your compass is swinging, you're trying to motherfucking stroke people's egos and shit, virtual signal and all that, slow that down. Now motherfuckers will use you, abuse you, chew you up, spit you out, take you for everything you got, you know what I mean? And leave you on the side of the road holding your neck. And you and your family, man, y'all just gotta eat that at the end of the day. There's a lot of motherfuckers, man, they was shining, they was doing a thing, they was the next one up, they was supposed to hold it down, but you start getting cool with everybody, or you start trying to disrespect everybody unnecessarily, and you find yourself put in a box. And you just gotta stay there, hold that down, and do what the fuck it is that you do, you know what I mean? You'll forever be banished in a certain sense, and you'll be some YouTube nigga or whatever the fuck, some nigga in the back of a comedy club holding it down for a couple hundred people. Whatever it is, you'll continue to do you if you're good at what you do. But it's certain motherfuckers that are able to navigate this whole shit, step on motherfuckers' toes, spit that shit, make people laugh, do what they gotta do, but also, like I said, broker the deals and get themselves from point A to point B to point C to the point where they're moving on up to the east side. So it's really important at the end of the day that people understand the difference between business and trying to befriend people, and mixing the two together will never motherfucking work, and you'll find yourselves arguing, going back and forth, getting the short end of the stick and all types of bullshit at the end of the day. So Uncle Nick is here to win, and I like the fact that there's people from New York, Nori, this one, that one, Desus, Mero, even Joe Bunn from Jersey, motherfuckers holding it down and putting in this work, but creating a lane for certain motherfuckers that got something to say, man. Y'all just watch out for Uncle Nick. He's creeping on the come up. You heard me? But y'all let me know what y'all think in the comment section. Is Uncle Nick on point? You know what I mean? You gotta watch yourself when you're doing business. Fuck a friend. Yeah. But anyhow, if you appreciate the content, get up in the description box and drop a donation. Drip, drip, drip fills the bucket. And other than that, I'm out this motherfucker, man. Y'all be safe. Y'all be smart. Y'all be easy. Y'all be well. Hold it down. Don't do anything stupid on the internet. And I'll see y'all soon, man. Peace. So we're back outside with my man Kevin right now. Got some new kicks on his feet, you know what I'm saying? Over there styling and profiling. Got him some nice Adidas. And you were saying something about angels on earth. Let the people know.
If anybody out there is wondering, could there really be such a thing as an angel on earth? Well, I'm here to tell you there is. There's one standing right next to me. My man came out of nowhere, doesn't know me from a can of paint. Came to and put shoes on my feet, literally. I had no shoes this morning. I didn't think anything could get any worse till this morning. And God showed up and said, I got you. He sent one of his soldiers. I'm so grateful. Thank you.
Uncle Nick doing the motherfucking work.
Thank you, Uncle Nick.
And the Wolf Pack.
And the Wolf Pack. Thank you.
All right, we out this motherfucker. Peace.